In fact, most IDEs are extensible through the use of plugins. And by the way, note that plugins might be called differently on different platforms. For example, if you're using a Microsoft Visual Studio, plugins are normally called add-ins. But the concept is more or less the same. So what is a plugin? Well, let's imagine our IDE to be this box. A plugin is additional functionality that you can actually plug into this box so that this box starts offering more features to the user. For example, you can add to Eclipse the CheckStyle plugin, which, paraphrasing the CheckStyle website, helps you ensure that your Java code complies with a set of coding standards by inspecting the code and pointing out items that deviate from a defined set of coding rules. Again, this is a functionality the core of Eclipse doesn't have. You can add the CheckStyle plugin, and this functionality will become available in the IDE. Another example of plugin is the eGit plugin, which adds support for the Git version control system in Eclipse. And actually, this is something that we'll cover in detail. We'll have a demo, and we will actually use it throughout the class. So I'm not going to say anything more about the eGit plugin for now. But again, what the plugin will do is to add the Git functionality to Eclipse, a functionality that is not in the core of Eclipse, and that is available to the user after you add the plugin.